For any culture, the land that that culture is from shapes the nature of the culture itself.
We lived off the land. This was our high rise. These mountains were our high rises.
And ohia being such a dominant tree in the landscape has affected the way Hawaiians view the world.
Ohia was used in musical instruments. It was used in tools of farmers. It was used in weapons of warfare.
It plays a critical role in the ecosystem. It really anchors the forest.
And without ohia, we wouldn't have a purpose.
And I called and I was like, you know, something's wrong with my trees.
This is the sort of an epicenter of disease here. All these trees have died in the past couple of years.
Wow, I built my house to look at my beautiful forest and now it's dead.
So when we cut into it, there we go, first chop.
You're not going to have very many trees at all after, say, about 10 years' time.
If the ohia people's roots don't break up the landscape, and their fuzzy leaves cannot collect water anymore, where do you think your water is going to come from?
This is a very important disease. It puts a lot of stress and pressure to do good work and try to get these recommendations out quickly.
You know, if these forests go away, they're never coming back the same way. So I think we really have to protect what we have.
What I hope that we can do is manage it, to restore some areas that are hit by it, to make it so it doesn't spread to new areas.
We are a part of nature. The forest takes care of us, and with this disease happening, we need to learn more about how to take care of the forest.
You know, it's that Hawaiian saying, you know, you take care of the aina takes care of you.